Follow me. I will.
Calendar is celebrated as Vocation Sunday. This year it falls on 21st of June. Have you ever heard about the Vocation Sunday?
Vocation Sunday? Has it got anything to do with vacation? I mean, is it a day meant for fun and frolic?
Oh, come on, Chris. It's not a Vacation Sunday, but a Vocation Sunday. Let me explain. Vocation Sunday is a Sunday set aside each year for prayer and reflection, so that vocation to priesthood and consecrated life may increase.
But what is meant by vocation?
Vocation is a call from God to a distinctive state of life in which the person can reach holiness. Do you guys need any more clarity in this topic? Alright then, let's hear it from Father Zacharias.
Dear friends, my dear children, today we are celebrating Vocation Day. Vocation means it is a God's call. Generally in the church, Vocation Day we promote to the priestly life and religious life. The core of vocation, it is God's calling. It is not your personal decision. It is God's decision. The Bible says, Jesus called the people to whom he loved the most. It is absolutely a God's decision. And even though generally it is a vocation for priesthood and religious life, and basically the call to serve Jesus, it is for everybody. So always remember, whatever you do in your life, you have a vocation to love Jesus, serve Jesus, to glorify Jesus. Everything you do, absolutely, it is for greater glory of God. And remember, ask your voice, inner voice, to the Holy Spirit, what is my vocation? How I can love Jesus, serve Jesus? Maybe simple, ordinary life. How I can contribute great service to other people also and make your life meaningful. God is speaking to us. God is calling us to do something for God, for God's glory. That is the Vocation Sunday. Thank you. God bless you. Every day ask these days, Lord, speak to me. Lord, vocation, it is a call. Lord, speak to me. The Lord said to Samuel, and Samuel said, here I am. Amen.
Oh, that's good. Now I can understand it very well. But friends, sometimes it happens that many children think that they possibly have the calling to a consecrated life, but they are not sure about it. How can they help themselves?
Well, that's easy. They can attend a retreat. It's called as a discernment retreat. Every year our diocese organizes this type of retreat for all those who aspire to become priest and nun.
Apart from the parish priests and nuns in the parishes are always available to help them to discern their vocation.
But many people fear to say strong yes. Due to peer pressure and pressure from one's own family. How can a person overcome it?
See, if God is calling you, then He will also make a way to execute His plans in your life. Whatever may be the situations around, it does not matter. You just need to surrender yourselves to God and He will take care of the rest.
Have you heard about Dolores Hart? She was an Hollywood actress who became a nun. Then we have Father Rob Gallier. He is known as singing priest. His journey from being a troubled teen to a Catholic priest is simply impressive. Then we have Reverend Father Sijo Chanada. He was a radio jockey, therefore he is known as RJ Father. Then we have Reverend Father Kevin Muttakil. He is known as the first Siro Malabar priest born and brought up in the US. As now we all know, in today's time there were many professionals like doctors, nurses and engineers who left everything and heeded the call from God.
Do you think all these people have to battle with peer pressure? Of course yes, and that might have been much more than what we could imagine. But see how God led them through those challenges, and today they are just living a life serving God. Isn't that beautiful?
Yes, you are right. So friends, I feel we must pray that more and more vocations arise. Let us specially pray that let there be more children and youth who respond to God's call from our parish.
So friends, we hope all of you understood what this Vocation Sunday is all about. Now, let's join our hands and close our eyes.
Loving and generous God, we thank you for your tender mercies and unfailing love. Lord, raise up the dedicated and generous people who will serve you as sisters, brothers, deacons, priests, and lay missionaries. Open our hearts to your call. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.